Holy, 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 Lord God Almighty, God in three persons, blessed Trinity.
Happy Trinity Sunday, everyone. My name is Michelle Pirraglia, and I'm the Director of Faith Formation here at St. John's, as well as a lifelong parishioner, and I'm blessed to be sharing the Gospel Reflection with you this week. When I think of Trinity Sunday, I think of two things: family, and that famous scripture passage we hear in the Gospel today, John 3:16. So first, just a little bit about family. I grew up here at St. John's and attended Our Lady Queen of Apostles School. I have a lot of fond memories from the parish and OLQA. My parents were very involved with parish life at St. John's. My dad was a part of several ministries and made sure that I stayed connected as well, whether it was children's choir, altar serving, youth ministry. And he also sent me to OLQA so that I could live my faith out every day in school and really have faith be a part of my life. But there was a particular time when I remember it all coming together, understanding that the parish is a family. I was about 7 years old, and it was around this time of year, late May, early June, and my mom, who had multiple sclerosis, had a flare-up, and she ended up paralyzed. During that time, which obviously was a difficult transition for our family, I ended up living at several different houses, passed around from relatives and friends, including some parishioners at the time. And I just remember also how much the parish community came together to support my parents, and neither of them ever wavering in their faith. It certainly wasn't easy or perfect, but our parish family really helped us through this time. Now, why am I talking about family? Well, it's Trinity Sunday, and one of the most beautiful revelations that we have in Scripture is that God is not a far-off, distant being. God is with us. And not only is he with us, but it's revealed that God is a family. God is a communion of persons, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. One God, three persons. I'm not going to get much deeper than that. There are plenty of saints, theologians, and doctors of the church who speak much more eloquently than I on the Holy Trinity, which at the end of the day is a great mystery of our faith. But we should take this opportunity to reflect on that mystery today, and how God is a communion of persons. God is calling us to unity as a family because we were made in the image and likeness of God. We were made to reflect that family, to reflect that love. It can be difficult to see that in these times where there is so much division, in these times during the pandemic when we may either be feeling like we're a little too much in communion with our families, we're a little too close, having spent all this time together, or maybe that's been a good thing, or we feel isolated because we're separated from our family and we haven't seen them in a long time. I know it's been a struggle, but we are called to that communion. I've been working on social media along with our music director, Andrew McKeon, and so many of you have submitted wonderful reflections and thoughts and prayers and hopes. And it's been such a blessing to connect with everybody, to find that communion online. So that idea of family and community, it goes beyond our little circle of family and it spreads to the parish community, but it also spreads to the whole world. And that kind of leads me to John 3:16, which is a part of the gospel that we hear today. And I just want to read from my father's Bible. He was very devoted to scripture, and this is well loved and well used, and it's something that's very special to me. And I'm not just going to read from John 3:16, because while that's an amazing passage, I think the second verse is just as important. For God so loved the world that he gave his only son, that whoever believes in him may not die, but may have eternal life. God did not send his son into the world to condemn the world, but that the world might be saved through him. We live in very challenging times. There's a lot of pain and anger and division, and it can be very easy to get discouraged and to forget those reasons for hope that we expressed as a parish. I think that this gospel today is reminding us that Jesus came into the world not to condemn, but to forgive and to save us. And so we have to bring that light of Christ and that good news that Jesus wants our salvation to everyone. It's not going to be easy. We're supposed to be a family. And sometimes families are a mess. And sometimes it's hard to communicate. And sometimes we don't listen well. And sometimes we get angry. And sometimes things don't turn out the way that we'd like. But we always remember at the end of the day these words that God loved us so much that he gave up his only son for us, not to condemn us, but for our salvation. I miss you all. I hope you're doing well. God bless and have a great week.